Hello and welcome to our video tutorial. In this lesson, we will be looking at Unit 2, Lesson 3, Graphs of Functions. Please remember to pause or rewind the video as needed. Let's begin. For our fluency questions, number one, we have a graph given over to the right-hand side, and the graph is some random function f of x. Find the value of each function, the function of each of the following. So what we're going to do in number one, when it says find the value of the function, it basically means find out what y equals. In each of these cases, you are finding out what y equals because these are the x values. Okay, and that's how we're going to do it. So taking the first one into account, x equals -7, I go to my graph, -1, -2, -3, -4, -5, -6, -7 is right here. Go down to the graph, and that point right there is y equals -1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, -6. Here on this one, we're evaluating f of 4, meaning f evaluated at x equals 4. So we're going to go x equals 1, 2, 3, 4. Then I'm going to go up to the graph right there, and the value of that part of the function is y equals 1. Okay, evaluating the function at x equals 0. Is right here. We're going to go, 0 is right here. I'm going to go up to the graph right there. You can see it is on the number line, 1, 2, 3. And then finally, evaluating the function at x equals 9. 1, 2, let's see. We're going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Go down to the graph. And we can see that that has a value of about -4, a y value of -4. Okay, so part 1A was all about finding the y values or the value of the function for a specific value of x. Now part B is going backwards, really. We're given the y value and you're looking for how many x values. Now it says how many, it doesn't say what they are. Okay, and we want to illustrate this on the graph by circling it. Okay, we are going to circle them. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to y equals 5, and let's make a kind of a horizontal line across at x, y equals 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'll make a line all the way across. Now you'll notice it's going to intersect the graph right here, right here, and right here. So that means there are exactly 3 times. So how many times, how many values? There are 3 x values because it crosses the function 3 times. Okay, now part C, what is the y-intercept of this relation? Well, y-intercept is where the graph crosses the y-axis. So I go to my y-axis, which is right here. And where is my graph crossing the y-axis? Right there at 3, y equals 3. State the maximum and minimum values of this graph. Okay, the maximum is the overall highest point. The minimum is the overall lowest point. So the maximum, if you guys look, the highest point of the graph And it's going to be a y value because maximum minimum mean the height and depth of the graph. So the y, the highest y value and the lowest y value. Well, right here, there's the highest y value, and that corresponds to a value of 6. So y equals 6 is our maximum for the graph. Our minimum, on the other hand, that would be way down here, and that is corresponding to negative 1, negative 2, negative 6. Explain why the graph represents a function. Well, we said in an earlier lesson that the... I'm going to erase some of these here. There we go. Okay, sorry. We explained in an earlier lesson that functions are defined when every x value, every input, has its own output. Well, there's another way to do this, and it's called vertical line test. The way vertical line test is, if you draw a vertical line, it can only pass through the graph once. So I'm going to take a line, a vertical line, a very big line, and I'm going to move it several spots around the graph. If you notice, no matter where this line is, all the way along the graph, it only intersects the graph one time. So when it's here, it's only intersecting the graph once. When it's here, it's only intersecting once. When it's here, it's only intersecting once. When it's here, it's only intersecting once. And so on. For every x value on the graph, there's only one y value, meaning the vertical line only intersects once. So that is how we can visualize it a little bit more efficiently, a little more quickly, okay? So the function passes what is called the vertical line test. This means a vertical line will pass through each x value only one time. Okay, just one time. Now, for number two, it says consider the function f of x equals, and here, let me reduce this real quick. There we go. We're given a function f of x equals 3 times the quantity 2 minus x and then minus 2. So what we're going to do is we're going to compute that in the table. Then we're going to take our xy ordered pairs and we're going to graph that information over to the side. Okay, let's take a look at this. I'll zoom in on the table here. All right, so we're going to go. I'm going to copy down this function multiple times, leaving x as kind of an open space. So 3 times 2 minus, and then leave a space for x, minus 2 equals, and then I'm literally going to copy this down 4 more times, okay? You do the same. Now, for the first one, you're plugging in for x, right? Negative 2. So 2 minus a minus 2, well, that's going to be 4. So this part is 4 times 3 is 12. 12 minus 2 is 10. So I get an ordered pair of negative 2, that's the x, and 10, that's the y. That's my xy coordinate pair. Same idea. I'm going to take negative 1. I'm going to plug it in here. OK, Okay, so 2 minus a minus 1. Well, minus a minus is plus. So 2 minus a minus 1 is 3. Times 3 is 9. Take 9 and subtract 2, and we get 7. So our ordered pair here is going to be negative 1, 7. Okay, plugging in 0 for our input, our x value. 2 minus 0 is 2, times 3 is 6. 6 minus the 2 would be 4. So my ordered pair would be 0, 4. Plugging in the 1 right here. We're going to go 2 times 1 is 1. Times 3 is 3. Take 3 minus 2. 3 minus 2 would be 1. So my ordered pair would be 1, 1. Okay, and then finally, plugging in 2 for this, we get 2 minus 2, which is 0, times 3, which is still 0. Now take 0, subtract 2, you are at negative 2. So my ordered pair here would be 2, negative 2. Now, plot those. So negative 2, 10. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, negative 5, negative 1, negative 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, just getting my scale. All right. So we're going to go negative 2 and then up 10. There's your first point right there. So that's negative 2, 10 right there. Okay, negative 1, 7. So go negative 1 and then up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 right there. That would be negative 1, 7. 0, 4. So stay at 0. Go up 4. That would be right there, 0, 4. 1, 1. Go up 1 over 1. That would be right there. And then 2, negative 2. That would be down here. Okay, and you can see that this would form a line if you drew it through your dots, your points. Number 3 and number 4 are our application and reasoning part of our independent assignment. So let's take a look at this, okay? Again, try and pause and try and do as much as you can and check your answers with this video tutorial, okay? Part 3. The following graph represents the cost of a phone plan after a certain number of text messages used in a month. Analyze the graph to answer the following questions. How much would you have to pay if you used 500 text messages and 1,800 text messages? Well, let's take a look at the actual graph. So here on the y-axis, it's cost in dollars. So you can see this would be $10, $20, $30, $40, $50, $60, $70, $80, $90, $100. So you can see this scale is going by tens. Okay. The other one, the x-axis, is number of text messages sent in hundreds. So this would be 100, 200, 300, 400, 500 text messages, 600, 700, 800, 900, 1,000 text messages, 100, 1,100, 1,200, 1,300, 1,400, 11, 12, 13, 14, 1,500 text messages, and 16, 17, 18, 19, 2,000. Text messages. So when you're dealing with a graph, always try and find out what the scale of each axis is as you're trying to read and interpret the graph. So 500 text messages, I would go to that part of the graph and I would go up here and I could see that that corresponds to $30. Okay, 1,800, that would be here, go up, that corresponds to $80. Okay, so this is about being able to use the input-output nature of functions for graphical interpretation. So just be able to interpret the information from a graph. So now part B says interpret f of 14 equals 60. Well, remember, this is the input, and this is the output. So what is this going to mean? The input is the number of text messages. So 1,400 text messages are going to result in an output. What's the output? Cost. Will cost $60. What might have caused the graph to begin to increase at 800 text messages? Right here. Why did the graph start to increase? Well, most cell phone plans actually charge you up to a certain number of texts. And most likely at 800 text, overage charges begin. So after 800 texts, overage charges. So overage charges means charges that go over your plan. So overage charges would begin. That's at least how we can interpret the information here. That's one way to interpret it. All right, and then in our final question number four, we're gonna take a look at part A, B, C, D, E of what is called a piecewise function, okay? Now, a piecewise function basically means the function is only true for different parts, okay? So what does that mean? Well, if we look at the piecewise function, it says f of x is equal to two different things. Well, how could it possibly be equal to two different things? Well, f of x is equal to this function here, 3 minus 2x, if x is less than or equal to 1. X values one or less. Okay, that's what that means. X values that are 1 or less. Okay, what does this mean? F of x will equal this function, 2x minus 1, for all values that are greater than 1. That means x values more than 1. Okay, so what do we have here? We have x equals 5. That's more, 5 is more than 1, isn't it? Which means, which function are we going to use? We are going to use this one here. So 2, we're going to use 2x minus 1 for this problem right here. So we're going to go 2 times 5 minus 1. Well, 2 times 5 is 10, minus 1 is 9. Now, negative 2 is less than 1, which means you're going to use the other function, which is 3 minus 2x. So 3 minus 2 times the negative 2 here that you're plugging in for x would be 3. Now, minus a minus is plus, mind you. So 2 times 2 is 4. This would be 3 plus 4 or 7. So it says carefully evaluate f of 1. What about at 1? Well, you have to remember which equation do we use? Because where does 1 fall into play? Well, it said we use the first equation for all x values that are 1 or less than 1. So when x equals 1, we're going to use the top equation. So we're going to evaluate f of 1 is going to be 3 minus 2 times 1, or 3 minus 2, which is 1. Okay, part C, we're going to evaluate the piecewise function depending on what we get. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna kind of figure this out based on what my x values are first, okay? So negative 1 is less than 1. So I'm gonna use 3 minus 2x to evaluate this one here. Zero. Well, that's less than 1 also. So I'm still going to use 3 minus 2x. Okay. 1, well, 1, it says we're going to use the top function for all values that are 1 or less. So I'm still going to use the top part of the piecewise function. Now, 2 is greater than 1, so that means I'm going to use the other bottom function, 2x minus 1. And then 3 is also greater than 1, so I'm also going to use 2x minus 1. So that will help you figure out which part of the piecewise function you're using, and then you can evaluate that part. So this would be 3 minus 2 times negative 1, which is 3 plus 2, which is going to be 5. This is going to be 3 minus 2 times 0, which is equal to 3 plus 0, which is equal to 3. This is going to be 3 minus 2 times 1, which is equal to 3 minus 2, which is equal to 1. This is going to be 2 times 2, there's your x value of 2, minus the 1. Well, 2 times 2 is 4, minus the 1 is 3. And finally, 2 times 3 minus 1, 2 times 3 is 6, minus the 1 is 5. So if you put these together, you will have a negative 1, comma 5 ordered pair, 0, 3, 1, 1, 2, 3, and 3, 5. Now we need to graph those. Okay, so what do we graph? We are graphing, I'll choose a different color here. Negative 1 up 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's our first point right there. 0, 3. That would be right here. 1, 1. That would be here. 2 up 3. And then 3 up 5. So you're kind of seeing this kind of shape develop. Almost kind of looks like a V. What is the minimum value of the function? Circle that point and indicate its value on the graph. Well, that's the lowest point right there. And so that would be at a value of y equals 1. I hope you found the tutorial to be helpful. Remember to pause or rewind as you need to. Thank you. See you next time.